On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Hello, my friends. May you all be blessed abundantly in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, for the glory of the Lord Jesus. I wanted to answer a question that many people have asked, especially in these last days. Many people have said, Bishop Macedo, I understand very well the proposal of the campaign of Israel. I understand. However, I participated in campaigns of Israel, and I still haven't reached my dreams. I have taken part of many campaigns of Israel, and I know that many people receive. However, I haven't received as yet. Why? What is the reason? Why hasn't it happened in my life if I made my sacrifice? So you're going to know why you haven't received as yet. And not only you, anybody, whether they do or don't do the campaign of Israel, if they don't manifest a true faith, a sincere faith, a pure faith, a total faith, it is obvious that they are going to be frustrated, because with God there isn't a half faith. Either it is or it isn't. There's no more or less with God. It is or it isn't. Jesus has spoken this in another way, in a clear way, a transparent way, as to why many people are not able, although they climb the altar, they're not able to reach their dreams. Look what Jesus says. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. So what happens? God, He doesn't want half of our heart. He does not accept 99% of our heart. It is 100%. And He sees that our heart is or isn't 100% placed on the altar before the offering we present on the altar. Because our offering, it represents what is inside of us. For example, now we are approaching Christmas. For sure, many people are thinking the following: what is the present that I'm going to give to my son, my father, my mother, my daughter, my wife, for my girlfriend, my boyfriend? What present? What can I give for the person whom I love? So, according to the level of love that you have for that person, then you are going to put all your strength, you're going to sacrifice and bring a present to that person. If you love the person more or less, you're going to give a more or less present. If you love that person a little bit, if you don't have so much love for that person, you can even give a present, any kind of present. It will not stop being a present. However, the truth is, the present that we give to someone we love, it shows, the present shows, the gift shows the level of love we have for that person. For that person who we say we love. So, my friends,
Qual é o qual tem
what
sido?
Is,
qual tem sido tesouro
or what has
maior
been
que você
the
tem?
Greatest treasure you have?
Qual é o seu tesouro?
What is your treasure?
Porque você tem dado
because
presentes
you have given gifts to God, offerings to God.
Você tem sido fiel,
you have been faithful in your offerings.
Você tem realmente
however,
colocado o seu maior
have you really placed your greatest treasure on the altar?
Essa é a
this is the question.
Porque
because
onde o seu coração
where your heart is,
ali estará o seu tesouro.
Your treasure is there also.
Ou o seu tesouro.
So,
tesouro,
if your treasure
é,
is
prova
your treasure proves where your heart is.
Há pessoas,
there are people
que se casam,
they get married
e dizem assim,
and they say like this.
O homem fala
the man
mulher,
tells the woman or vice versa.
Fala assim,
listen,
eu dou tudo pra você,
I give
tudo que você
all
quer,
that you want. I give you everything.
Está aqui cartão de crédito.
The credit card is here. You can buy
quiser.
Whatever you want.
Você pode comprar carro,
you can buy a car, a plane, a yacht.
Viajar,
you can travel.
Casa,
you can buy a house. You can buy whatever
quiser.
You want.
Só tem uma
however,
coisa
there's one thing that I require from you.
É que me deixe livre.
Let me be free. I want to be free. I don't want to be tied to you. If I want to go home and stay with you, that's good. But if I don't, if I want to be with other women, you are not going to bother
me.
You are not going to annoy me. Then I ask, you woman, you man, that wants a love by your side forever, are you going to accept this situation? Are you going to subject yourself to these gifts in exchange for infidelity of the person who you love? Of course not. Well, that's what I think. I would not accept it. Neither would my wife accept me to have everything but not have me. So you can imagine it's the same with God. Many people place the importance of money, the financial stability on the altar. However, their hearts keeps the greatest treasure. And what is their greatest treasure? Is the lover? Is the lover? Is the unbalanced life, the addiction? So the person has their heart subject to something else with other things in which for that person is their treasure. Now, God doesn't want your money, your offering. God wants your heart completely.
So,
meanwhile, you don't renounce what is wrong that you do. What is it worth for you to place on the altar your offerings?
Of course,
the altar doesn't owe anyone. However, you are not going to have the plenitude of God until you give your plenitude of life. That's how it works. You want an answer from God for you to have a new life, for you to have an absolute new life. The Bible says that God does all things new, especially your life. You want a new life, then you have to go to the altar with everything, my friend. With your treasure, with your heart, with your sins. You're going to place everything on the altar. Your entire life, all that you are, all that you hope to be, all that you have or hope to have, you're going to place it on the altar, and from the altar, what you want will arrive. What you desire the most will come. That's how it works. Jesus teaches this. And he even said, my Father does not give the Spirit by measure. He does not give the Holy Spirit by measure. The Holy Spirit is not given by measure. Now, if he doesn't give the Holy Spirit by measure, how is he going to accept your life, my life, by measure?
Não tem sentido.
That doesn't make any sense.
É tudo por
It's all for all. Either it is or it is not. So if you want the plenitude, the divine plenitude to dwell inside of you, especially the Holy Spirit, if you want the Spirit of God to descend upon you and make of you His temple, His dwelling place, then you have to place all on the altar. It is your all for the all that He has to offer you.
Agora, é claro,
now it's clear. Your all. What is your all? How much is your all?
Se você tem uma vida desgraçada,
if you have a disgraced life, you have a spoiled life,
perdida,
a lost life,
uma vida sem
you have a life with no perspective, you have been a person that is abandoned
vida,
by
amigos,
life, by friends,
parentes,
even by your own parents.
Você tá sozinho,
you are alone.
Você é uma
you are a person. That does not have anyone's care. You live completely isolated from everything and everyone, as if you're in the middle of the desert. You have no one by your side. And when you place your life, you're placing a life that has no value. Has no value for this world. And probably even for yourself. However, when you place your all on the altar, God places His all in you, which is the Holy Spirit. So this is the secret. That's why many people, they don't receive, the answer from God in the campaign of Israel, because they simply don't renounce their sins. They don't let go of their own life. They don't renounce the prostitution. They don't renounce what they know they have to let go. It's their treasure. This treasure they don't give. This treasure is mine. No, it's mine. So there's no negotiation. This person should even climb the altar with the offer because it's not going to solve the problem. It's all for all. If it's not all for all, there's no faith, there's no chemistry, there's no marriage, there's no covenant, there's no answer. This is the truth. There's no other explanation. I only know this answer. It's all for all. If you have courage to place your all on the altar, all your life on the altar, it's clear that you're going to have faith to receive the all from God. It's like this. You give, you receive. You don't give, you don't receive. Let this be at your criteria what you're going to do. Because your life is yours. And only you have authority upon it. Only you have power upon it. And God placed the altar available for those who believe, for those who have faith to give. Because those who have faith to give, obviously, will have faith to receive. And it's not worth for you to look at others, envy with others, because they gave the best and they received the best. You didn't give the best and you expect the best to come to you. It's all for all. Either it is or it isn't. This is the campaign of Israel. So, the names of those who are giving everything, they're placing their all on the altar, we're going to take their names to Mount Sinai. And there we're going to cry out, my father, this person gave their all. However, if you pretend to be giving your all and you are not, then, my friend, it's not going to work. The prayer is not going to work for you. It's only going to work for those who truly are placing their all on the altar.